Hello, good morning everyone and welcome to today's class. Hope you are able to see the screen. Let me confirm. Yes. Good morning everyone, and yesterday we were looking at Mathematics 2 chapters named Body Plateaus, right? Let's quickly recap. First thing, the definition: a closed four-sided figure is called as quadrilateral. Then the family tree, parallelograms and trapezoids. It is classified into parallelograms and trapezoid. Parallelogram has two pair of parallel and equal sides, whereas trapezoid has only one pair of parallel sides. And then further, parallelograms are classified into rectangle and rhombuses, where square is a special form of rectangle and rhombus. Then we see the properties of parallelogram. The adjacent sides are equal. The sum of adjacent angles is supplementary, that is, sum of the adjacent angles is 180 degrees. Then the opposite sides, they are congruent, the opposite angles are congruent, and the diagonals, they bisect each other. Okay, these are the basic four properties of parallelogram. When I say that these are the properties of a parallelogram, that means these properties are applicable for rhombus, rectangle, and square. Because just now we saw the flow chart. So as per the flow chart, whatever the properties are of parallelogram, all these properties will be there for the rectangle, rhombus, and square. So when I say these are the properties of basic properties of parallelograms, these will be true for rectangle, square, and rhombus also. Okay, we will be using all of them today in problem set 5. Okay. Next, in case we are asked to prove that a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then we use these four properties. Firstly, we can start by proving that if the opposite sides are equal, then that's a parallelogram. If two pairs of opposite angles are congruent, then that's a parallelogram. In case the diagonals bisect each other, then we can say that yes, it's a parallelogram. And finally, if only one pair of opposite sides is parallel and equal, then we can say that it's a parallelogram. Then we see the diagonal special, the special properties of diagonals. Okay, just by the property of the diagonal, we can identify which type of quadrilateral it is. Okay, we can classify them into rectangle, rhombus, and square. So rectangle has only one property for diagonal, rhombus has two, and square has both rectangle and rhombus. Again, if you remember the flow chart, everything becomes easy, right? So for a rectangle, the diagonals are just congruent. For a rhombus, the diagonals, they bisect the opposite angles, and the diagonals, they are perpendicular bisectors of each other. Likewise, for a square, all these three properties are true. That means for a square, the diagonals are equal, the diagonals are perpendicular, bisectors of each other, and the diagonals, they bisect the pair of opposite angles also. Okay, then we see the trapezium. Trapezium has only one pair of parallel sides, right? And special case, suppose that the non-parallel sides are equal, then we say that is isosceles trapezium, okay? And since it's an isosceles trapezium, the base angles and the top angles, they will be equal. Then we see the theorem of midpoint. Theorem of midpoint of two sides of a triangle. It says if the segment joining midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel, it says that if there are two midpoints, if two sides have two midpoints, then the line joining these two midpoints will be parallel to the third side, and of course, it will be parallel and half of the third side. Okay, so how can we write it out for this diagram? We can say that if P and Q are the midpoints, then PQ will be parallel to BC and PQ will be half of BC. And then we see the converse. The converse states that if one side has a midpoint and let's say the point which is extending from that midpoint, the line which is the line segment which is extending from that particular midpoint, it is parallel to the base, then we can say the other side has a midpoint. Okay, so where do we use converse of midpoint theorem? Anywhere if you are asked to prove that a point is a midpoint, we use the converse of midpoint theorem. And anywhere if you are asked to prove the two lines are parallel and midpoints are given, then you can just identify that you need to use the midpoint theorem. Okay, so this is how it looks like for this diagram. It will be given that D is the midpoint and it will be given that DF is parallel to BC. Therefore, we can say that E is the midpoint. Okay, so based on all these properties, we will be doing problem set 5. We start with question number 5. Okay. So let's draw out the diagram first. Diagonals PR and QS of a rhombus PQRS are 20 and 48 respectively. Find the length of side PQ. So it's a rhombus. How would the diagram look like? A rhombus like this. And then we are given the diagonals. Okay. Also, they have clearly mentioned the name. So let's use the same name. So that's PQRS. They have given that PR and SQ are these respectively. That means PR is 20 and QS is 48. So PR is 20 and QS is 48 centimeters. Okay. And what are we asked to find? We are asked to find PQ. Okay. So, solution. How can we start? Clearly, diagonals and rhombus. So, think about the property of rhombus with diagonals. What are the properties of diagonals for a rhombus? They just bisect each other, right? For a rhombus, what can we say? They just bisect each other. All right. So if they are bisecting each other, let me just a minute. Yeah. I show it to you over here. Just check the properties of diagonals for rhombus. The diagonals, they are perpendicular bisectors of each other. Okay. We are going to use this property because this depends for the length. Okay, so here we are. We use which property? That the diagonals of a rhombus, they are perpendicular bisectors of each other. Okay, so first we can state that PQRS is a rhombus. We are given that this is a rhombus. Therefore, what can we say? Therefore, the diagonals of a rhombus, or we can say, we know the diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular bisectors of each other. What does that mean? That means the central angle over here, this will be 90 degrees, and of course, this will be equal to this side, this side will be equal to this side. Let me name this as M. Okay. So therefore, what can we say? Angle M equals to 90 degree. And what else? SM will be equal to half of SQ, right? And likewise, PM will be equal to half of PR. Check everyone. I'm highlighting or I'm using these two sides. Check SM. SM will be equal to MQ, but SM will be also half of SQ. SQ is given to be 48, so that will be half of 48 SF. Likewise, we are looking at PM. PM is half of PR. Intentionally, we are using these two because we are going to use this triangle and the right angle to find the side. Okay, we are asked to find the length of side. Correct? So, just see. This is half of SQ. SQ, that is 48. So, half of 48 is 24 centimeters. And the other one, that is half of 20, which will be simply 10 centimeters. So, here I have PM. PM is 10. And SM. SM is 24. I have to find the length of the side PQ. Okay. Now, length of the side PQ will be equal to PS. It's one and the same thing. Why so? Because all sides are equal. You can start with this triangle also. It would be again the same thing, right? Instead of SM, I should have used just a minute. Okay, so instead of SM, I should have used MQ. All right, so this is same as MQ. And we can say, we can start with this triangle also. So we have PM, PM is 10, and we have MQ, MQ is, maybe I will just highlight it with green color, just check this triangle. We will refer to this triangle, okay, because we are asked to find PQ, so straight away using this triangle, okay. Just check, this is how you can always change the steps. So MQ is equals to SM, that is half of SQ, which is 24, okay. And that's how we begin. So this is right angle over here. Okay, this is 24. So we start with using Pythagoras theorem next, isn't it? This is a right angle triangle. We know two sides. We can find the third side by using Pythagoras theorem. So let's write it out. Very important to mention the name of triangle, which triangle we are using. Triangle PMQ. State angle M is 90 degrees. Therefore, what can we say? Therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, PQ square, PQ is the diagonal opposite to 90 degree. So PQ square equals to PM square plus MQ square, right? So 24 squared, PM is 10. So 10 squared plus MQ, that is 24 squared, right? 10 squared is 100. And 24 squared will be 576. Adding them, we get 676. And this is a Pythagorean triplet, actually. So we get PQ equals to square root of 676, which will be 26. Okay, so that's how we find PQ using two properties. First one, the diagonals property of a rhombus. And second one, the Pythagoras theorem. Let's look at next question. Diagonals of a rectangle PQRS are intersecting at point M, and we are given one angle and we are asked to find another. Okay, let's quickly draw a rectangle. You all can solve this problem with me so that you get an idea how to write out. You can try to answer few steps, or you can just think about the roadmap, how to work on this problem. Okay, the steps especially, which properties can we use? Think. Yeah. So this is a rectangle and the diagonals, they are intersecting at point M. So label this point as M. QMR is given to be 50 degrees. Let's highlight where is QMR. So this is QMR. We are given that QMR is 50 degrees, okay. So this angle is 50 degrees and we are asked to find angle MPS. Let's highlight that also, MPS, this angle. Okay, we are asked to find this angle. Let us label it as X, okay. Now, again, which property do we use here? So for this one, clearly you can see that we can use this triangle, okay, this triangle, the blue one. We can use this triangle and we have to find this angle. We can say by vertically opposite angles, this angle is 50 degrees. So we have this angle is 50 degrees and also check, we know that diagonals, check when they're highlighting diagonals, property of diagonals is the diagonals, they are congruent. That means PR is congruent to SQ. Diagonals are congruent and they bisect each other. Okay, property of a parallelogram, bisect each other. So all these small parts, they are equal. So this is equal to this. If these two sides are equal, then by isosceles triangle theorem, we can say that the base angles are equal, isn't it? So if the base angles are equal, we have one angle 50. Using the angle sum property, we can say, we can find the value of x. Okay, that's the roadmap. So let's write out the solution straight away because there is nothing much given in the question. So we start with stating that PQRS is a rectangle. Therefore, what can we say about the diagonals? Therefore, the diagonals are congruent and they bisect each other. Okay, so therefore we can say the diagonal, that is SQ, is equal or congruent like this. It is congruent to PR and they bisect each other. So half of SQ will be equal to half of PR. Now intentionally you have to use the blue sides. So half of SQ, you're going to use SM, okay? So SM will be congruent to half of PR, you would be using PM, okay? So it is congruent to PM, all right? So therefore, what can we say? Therefore, triangle, this blue triangle, SMP is a isosceles triangle. Therefore, the base angles will be equal, right? Two sides are equal. Therefore, the triangles is a isosceles triangle. Therefore, base angles, angle S is congruent to angle P, which will be X. Okay, we are setting it up to X. And then by using the angle sum property, so we can say in triangle SMP, angle S plus angle P plus angle M will be equal to 180 degree. How? By angle sum property. Okay. S and P both are X's and M is 50 degrees. This is equal to 180. So X plus X, that is 2X plus 50 equals to 180 degrees. And 2x will be equal to 130. And that's how we get the value of x to be half of 2, which will be 65 degrees. Okay, but we are asked to find angle MPS. So let's label it properly. MPS, this is equals to 65 degrees. Okay, so how did we start and which properties are we using here? Check everyone. Which properties are we using here? We started with vertically opposite angles. Okay, I have missed out that part. So please mention here, angle SMP is congruent to angle QMR, which is equal to 50 degrees. How? By vertically opposite angles. Okay, you can label this as equation one. And where are we using this? We are using this over here for angle F. So you can say, from 1, we got the M to be 50 degrees. Okay, that's how we can use that one. Okay, so we have used the vertically opposite angles property, then the diagonals property, right? And finally, the angle sum property of triangle. Using these three properties, we have solved this problem. Let's look at next one. This is again, important question, many times asked in exams. So let's look at the solution straight away, because each sentence which is given here, you can straight away, you'll get an idea, right? So just check. Firstly, we are given that segment AB, let me write it out properly. We are given that segment AB is parallel to segment PQ, and segment AB, we will write it out over here, segment AB is congruent to segment PQ. Okay, so this statement, this is given. All right, you can mention that this is given. So clearly, one pair is parallel and congruent. What can we say? We had used this symbol, parallel and congruent. Then this becomes, yes, it's a parallelogram. Right? So AB and PQ, check. If we refer to AB and PQ, which parallelogram do we see? We are given these two sides are parallel and equal. So which parallelogram do you see here? This parallelogram, correct? This will be the parallelogram. So you need to mention here which quadrilateral are we referring to. So in quadrilateral ABPQ, we are given that the opposite sides are parallel and equal. Therefore, it's a parallelogram. So you can just mention it here that opposite one pair of opposite sides so we are saying that one pair of opposite side is parallel and equal, therefore it's a parallelogram. Okay, we are going to use this property once again somewhere, so I'm going to keep that aside. Okay, so this is how we have used the first part. Now let's use the second part. Check AC and PR. Okay, check AC and PR. So this time we are looking at this quadrilateral. Okay, check, this is AC and PR. Okay, not this one, just a minute. AC and PR, these are parallel and equal. Okay, parallel and equal. Therefore, this will be a parallelogram. Correct, which one? Check this quadrilateral, right? We write out the steps. So in quadrilateral, A, B, C, D, that's A, P, R, C actually, A, P, R, C. We are given that segment AC is parallel to segment PR, and same time segment AC is congruent to segment PR. Therefore, we can say this part, therefore, since one pair of opposite side is parallel and equal, therefore that's a parallelogram, right? So what have we got? That this blue part, and let me highlight the other one, the yellow one, this one, both of them are parallelograms. And we are asked to prove this. BC is parallel to QR. So concentrate. BC is parallel to QR and BC is equal to QR. So that means clearly we have to prove that this is a parallelogram. Okay, I hope you all are getting the idea. We are given that two of them are parallelograms and we have to prove that the third one is a parallelogram. Okay, so how can we prove that it's a parallelogram? Right, just check using some properties from the yellow and some properties from the blue. We can prove that the red one is also a parallelogram. Okay, so just check for this yellow one, for this one, we can say this one. We can straight away say that AP is congruent to BQ and AP is parallel to BQ, right? So AP is congruent to BQ and AP is parallel to BQ. Okay, why so? Because since ABPQ is a parallelogram. Okay, that's the symbol for parallelogram. Also, if you look at the blue one, we can say that AP will be parallel to CR and AP will be congruent to CR. Okay, also AP is congruent to CR and AP is parallel to CR. Why so? Since the blue one, that is APRC, is a parallelogram. Just now we have proved that part, right? So from these two, what can we say? Just check, AP and AP, both of them are same. So we can equate these two. Likewise, for the parallel set, these two are same. We can equate these two. Getting? So from these two parts, what can we say? Therefore, BQ is parallel. BQ is congruent to CR and BQ is parallel to CR. Once again, check, we are equating these two parts. Okay. Now let me highlight this. Check, we have got that BQ is parallel to CR and BQ is equal to CR. Therefore, what can we say? Therefore, the red one is a parallelogram. Therefore, BCQR is a parallelogram. Okay. Right. And since it's a parallelogram, we can say that the other pair is also parallel and congruent. Okay. So therefore, we can say BC is parallel to QR and BC is congruent to QR. Okay. This is the property of a parallelogram. Hence, proof. All right. So which properties did we use here? Firstly, we have used this property that if one pair is parallel and congruent, then that's a parallelogram. And then we use the converse. Okay, just using the two properties, we have proved this question. We have solved it. Okay, let's look at next one. In this figure, we are given that it's a trapezium and AB is parallel to DC. Let's highlight. So AB is parallel to DC. Points P and Q are midpoints. Point P and Q are midpoints. I'm going to just highlight it like that. And segment AD and segment BC respectively, of course. Then prove that PQ is parallel to AB and PQ is half of AB plus CD. Okay, so we need to do some construction over here. We need to do some construction. Just a minute. Okay, so check AB and DC. So we can see that two are midpoints. Therefore, we can use the midpoint theorem, right? And whenever we are asked to show that something is parallel, something is half of something, it's related to either converse or the midpoint theorem. Okay, so here we have to extend or we have to join this line. Actually, like this, something like this. We extend this line so that AB is equal to that extended part. And this point, we are joining it to point A. Okay, it won't, just a minute. Like this. Okay, so to, let's label it. Yeah, maybe we can label this as point R. So what are we trying to do? We're doing the construction here. Let me write that out first. So construction, we are drawing the segment AR, or especially we are just extending AQ. Point R okay, which is on BC. Fine, so that's the construction. And what are we asked to prove? Two things. Firstly, that the lines are parallel, and secondly, something like this. Okay, so what are we given? AD is parallel to BC. Let's highlight that. AD is parallel, AB is parallel to DC, AB is parallel to DC. So AB will be parallel to the complete thing, right? And then P and Q are midpoints. So this side is equal to this side. Okay. Now, let's see how to begin. We start with solution. So we start with proving that this triangle and this triangle, they are, these two triangles are congruent to each other. Okay, one yellow triangle and one green triangle. Okay, why we are doing that? So somehow we are going to prove that this side and is equal to this side. Okay, so let's start with proving how these two triangles, they are congruent. Okay, so just check. Started like this. In triangle ABQ and the other triangle QCR, how they are congruent. So just check. We are given that Q is the midpoint. So BQ is equals to BQ is congruent to QC because Q is midpoint. It's given. Okay. And let's mention it out completely. PQ is a midpoint of BC. Okay. By vertically opposite angles, we can say that angle Q is congruent to angle Q. This is vertically opposite angles. These two angles, just check these two angles, they are congruent. And one more thing, by Z formation, look out everyone, just check here. By Z formation, these two sides, they are parallel. So by Z formation, we can say that this angle B is equal to this angle C. Okay, so we can say angle B is congruent to angle C by alternate angles. Or you can simply say from one. Okay, so you can start here with stating that AB is parallel to DC. Therefore, we can say AB is parallel to DR. Okay, how? Because DCR, they are forming one straight line. Okay, therefore, you can say angle B is congruent. Specifically, you can mention here angle ABC is congruent to angle BCR, that is the Z formation. Okay, how? By alternate angle property. Okay, therefore angle ABQ is congruent to angle QCR, and you can label this equation one. When we are proving the triangles to be congruent, we use this and say from one. Therefore these two triangles, they are congruent. Therefore triangle ABQ is congruent to triangle QCR by which property? Look at it. Here we have the angle, we have the side in between, and one more angle. So that will be ASA rule. Okay, so by ASA rule or ASA test, we can say that these two triangles, they are congruent. Now, once they are congruent, we are going to use corresponding sides of congruent triangles property. So here we can say that therefore AB is congruent to CR. What are we trying to do? We are trying to state that these two sides, they are equal. Okay, AB is equal to CR, and likewise, this part is congruent to this part. Okay, we were given that Q is the midpoint of BC. Okay, so therefore, we are using these two things. Why we are going to use, or how we are going to use it, let's see it in just 2 minutes. Check AB is congruent to CR, and also we can say AQ is congruent to QR. Okay, this is by CSCT, corresponding sides of congruent triangles, and label this as point 2. Okay, now we have to prove that PQ is parallel to AB. To prove this part, we are going to use that this is the midpoint and a particular triangle. Okay, look at the triangle. Which triangle are we going to use? We will be applying the midpoint theorem next. So check this triangle. Okay, so state that in triangle ADR, R and Q are midpoints, right? Therefore, what can we say? RQ is equal to half of DR, and this is P actually, this is P, okay? So what can we say? P and Q are midpoints, therefore, PQ is parallel to DR, and PQ is equal to half of DR. How? By midpoint theorem. Okay, everyone. And again, we will be using this. So just we can prove now PQ is parallel to DR. We have got that PQ is parallel to DR, and also DR is parallel to AB. So these two are parallel to each other, correct? So we have proved the first part now. Just check everyone. Since PQ is parallel to DR, this is, we have proved, we can say this is equation 3. This complete thing is equation 3. So PQ is parallel to DR from 3, and AB is parallel to DR, this is construction plus given. Okay, therefore, what can we say? DR, DR is same, so PQ is parallel to AB. We have proved the first part. So we can say PQ is parallel to AB. First part is proved. Now we have to concentrate on the second part. Okay, for the second part, we start from this. So start from this. We have proved that PQ equals to half of DR. We have proved this in step 3. And how can we write DR? So DR is DC plus CR, isn't it? So half of DC plus CR. But we have also proved that CR is equal to AB. Check. This is equals to half of. We have proved this. CR is AB from 2. That's hence proved. Okay, half of AB plus DC. It's one and the same thing. DC plus AB or AC plus DB. Okay, so that's how we prove it. Let me quickly recap on this one. So we started with the using the first thing, that was the alternate angle property. Okay, by alternate angle property, we said this angle is equal to this angle, and then we proved that the triangles are congruent by ASA property. Okay, then we are using the midpoint theorem. All right, using the midpoint theorem, we can prove these two parts, right, with some additional help from other sections, that is corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Okay, so in general, when you have all the properties with you, you can solve easily these type of application based questions, which have a combination of more than 2-3 type of properties. Okay, so just by looking at what is given and what is to be proved, you can think of the properties, and then by some logic or by some construction, you can prove that easily. Okay, also you need a lot of practice. You need to look at different type of questions, what type of questions can be asked. So please make sure that with the textual questions, with the in-text questions, with the practice set questions, with the problem set questions, you are also looking at some extra questions. Maybe you can use some reference books. Okay. So with that, we'll stop here. I hope you understood everything that we have covered in today's class. Thank you for joining, everyone, and have a nice day.